Julian, welcome back.
Thank you, Richard.
And I'd now like to focus on GRC's recent acquisition of Better Incorporated right here in New York City.
Yeah.
Julian, New York City's a long way from home for you. So why Better? Tell us more about the company, what they do, and what caught your attention.
Okay, so Better is a company that started about 2012 from some really bright guys who had been working in the financial services area. Okay. And they wanted to find a way of delivering compliance training in a more effective manner. They were doing too many hours of compliance training, and it was repetitive, and it didn't have the training impact that was required. So these guys came up with a solution, which is around adaptive e-learning.
Okay.
It changes what's being presented depending on where your skill level is and what competence you can already prove.
Wow.
And that way we can reduce the amount of training for people.
Interesting. Mm. So what do you think the opportunities are for growth with adaptive training? Where do you see Better providing market value and insight where it doesn't already exist? After all, as we've discussed, training is a crowded field, especially here in the U.S. I've even heard some call it a commoditized field. So where does adaptive training sort of bring us to a new level?
Well, I think it's not just adaptive training. It's the combination of adaptive training and our existing skills in building content.
Okay.
So our business has always been about producing high quality, you know, content for, you know, educated people. We're not wanting to build training that's condescending. We want to give professional training to professional people. And what we've got is a situation here where, you know, so many people have been doing their training year on year. It's the same training that they've been given. 90% of it they already know.
Right.
Right?
Because they've done it already.
They've done it. They've done it every year for the last 10 years. So they don't need to do this again. But we do need to record that they know it still. And we need to also understand that they may have forgotten some of that as well.
Okay.
So it may be that they do know it, but they need to be a bit, they need to be reminded on it. But it's not going to be the whole thing.
Got it.
Now, when we look at organizations, and I was talking to one of the big four accounting firms the other day, they said every hour of mandatory training costs them $35 million in opportunity cost.
Well, across personnel.
Across the whole lot. So, you know, and if you look at a major organization, even if you value in an individual's time at $100 an hour, you got 10,000 people or 100,000 people, that's a lot of money you're spending. And what is the outcome we're getting? Are we actually getting a more competent workforce, or are they just ticking the box and clicking through their training? And I suspect that a lot of people have done that.
Sure. Yeah. So if I understand this correctly, adaptive learning technology is calibrated to the individual learner, right?
Yeah.
What he or she needs to be refreshed on, and not to make them cover what they already have retained.
That's right.
Essentially.
Yeah.
Okay.
So we're taking people through a looping exercise.
Right.
You know, we've had training before where you can test out. You know, if you get 80%, you don't have to do it. You know, that's pretty basic. What we're taking people through is a process where they're going, having a few questions. If they get one or two wrong, they get a little piece of training on the bit that they got wrong.
Okay.
Come back, re-answer those questions, and keep going through it.
So that's saving everybody time and
money. Absolutely.
And for lack of a better word, it's a little more engaging because it's not a roll your eyes exercise.
Exactly. And we can then take the training up to the next level. If we can eliminate, you know, the 101 training, the basics, because we know that they've done that time and time again and they've proved their competence in that area, we can start presenting them with more complex and more interesting training that's not only going to be better for them, but it's also going to help minimize risk in the organization.
And like the GRC SALT platform, is the Better adaptive system, the e-learning system, is that across disciplines? Is it sexual harassment? Is it anti-bribery? Is
it
across?
Can be used for any form of training.
Okay.
And we'll be building, you know, custom training for different organizations who need, you know, multilingual adaptive learning that's responsive, that can go straight onto your phone if you're doing it on the train or something like that. Or we can, you know, offer from our library of content, and that just becomes something they subscribe to.
So there is a library, but yet it is able to sort of be customized to the needs of the client.
Sure. I mean, this is going to be most attractive to the larger organizations where they can see that, you know, money value of saving all that time. And those organizations need to have their own policies. They need to have, you know, specific elements of the training tailored to the different jurisdictions that they work in, and understanding of where that all flows through their job roles and the risk matrix.
But when I was thinking about adaptive training, I'm thinking, wow, this is a lot of content because it's really geared toward the individual. So, Julian, I was curious, where does the content come from? Who's actually writing the training, whether it's sort of a PowerPoint presentation or is it, you know, audio visual?
Yeah.
Where does it come from?
So we have a very large content team back in Australia.
Okay.
And they're very skilled at taking dry information, reams of information, and turning it into, you know, interesting and instructing adult education materials. And there's a difference there. We're not trying to train children. We're not trying to entertain. Right. We're not trying to make this into a game. We've got to get people through this in the fastest possible way, but also make it sink in. So there's a skill in taking that material and adapting it for adult education. So our guys can do that.
Okay.
And we're often just producing content as we go. So some new topic comes up or a new area of law. You know, anti-bribery wasn't a huge issue in 2005, but by 2015 it was our bestseller.
Sure.
Yeah. So, but also we get clients who come to us and say, look, we've got this training course. It's really long. It's really boring. We've been putting these people through it every year for the last 10 years. What can you do? Please help.
Oh, okay.
And so we'll take their materials and edit those back, change them around, you know, bring them back to them, work with that organization to make sure that we're hitting the right mark, that we're talking in the right sort of language for their culture, and that it is actually effective training because it's not just giving them reams of information. Mm-hmm. It's saying, well, let's break it up. Let's see what we can do.
Okay.
Let's codify it. Let's make sure we're getting the learning outcomes that we're trying to achieve.
I think that's an important point. So if a company has spent millions upon millions of their existing training system, it doesn't mean it needs to go in the rubbish bin.
No.
It can still be adapted and you sort of take it through your team and break it up to be more adaptive to the learner.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And the same goes for the technology. A lot of the organizations that are, you know, running out a lot of e-learning these days have invested heavily in learning management systems. We're not looking to replace that. Our systems plug and play with those platforms so that we can put up one course and just see how we're going without having to sort of get rid of that investment that's been in that whole organization.
Well, I read a little bit about how Better really focuses on the technology. So can you share a little bit more about that and where do you think the technology impacts the retention of compliance messages?
Well, I think the biggest issue we have in compliance is fatigue, followed very closely by forgetfulness.
Okay.
There's a wonderful theory, if you ever want to look it up, a guy named Ebbinghaus wrote this theory, which is about the curve of how we forget.
Okay.
And I think it's, you know, within a day we've forgotten 5%, within a year we've forgotten 95%, and something like that. It's a very steep curve that we go down. And what we're trying to do here is give people the reminders and the triggers without having to overburden them with the things that they do know.
Okay.
So if they can get short reminders and punchy reminders, that's going to sit with them for longer. And they might be more interested in doing the training more regularly. From another angle, the technology itself presents the content in a way which is more interesting. Mm-hmm. You know, e-learning has a bit of a reputation for being, you know, PowerPoints with questions.
Right.
You know, what can we do about that? Well, we can mix that up. You know, we can put
like
in
what?
We can put in a little bit of video. We can put in some YouTube messaging.
Mm-hmm.
We can put in voiceovers in multiple languages.
Okay.
So we're working with a company called ReadSpeaker out of Europe.
What's the name of them?
ReadSpeaker.
Okay.
And they're great. So what they've done is this technology that we can embed their technology into ours, and it will read the text on the page in your chosen language, in your chosen accent.
Fantastic.
So if you want to have it in Welsh, you can have it in Welsh, right? And you can choose the pace. So for us, particularly working in Asia Pacific, where all the training's in English, but English might be a second language for people, this is great. So they can slow it down, listen
Fantastic.
To it, maybe put a Malaysian accent on it if they want. So it's kind of fun, but it also gives us a really good training impact.
And for someone like myself who has every possible Apple device that I can get my hands on, my understanding it's also compatible with tablets and smart devices.
This is one of those things that everyone's asking for at the moment is responsive design. You know, so if we're taking it onto a tablet and it turns around and it fits that screen and we can answer those questions and we can do that when we're traveling, you know, I think that's a plus for all of us.
Sure.
You know, for someone like yourself who's always traveling, you don't want to have to be bound to your desktop computer. And I think that's happening in a lot of organizations too, where particularly in Australia, we're seeing a lot of organizations are hot desking, or they're calling it something else, but it's hot desking.
Sure.
You know, where you don't know where you're going to sit today or tomorrow.
That's right.
One of the organizations we're working with is rolling out the new Microsoft Surface to all staff. So the training has to be able to adapt to that. And it needs to be flexible enough that it's not static. We have to be able to keep it up to date. We have to change it without throwing out last year's course and starting again. The other thing that we do, which I think is relatively new and the better technology has helped us with this, is give the clients the ability to edit, which is really rare. And it seems like that's something that would be wanted by people. But what we found, building content, particularly custom content, is a collaborative exercise.
Right.
We don't know the ins and outs of every bank. They don't necessarily want to be writing every piece of anti-money laundering training or anti-bribery training. So there's a collaborative approach. But the old way of sending up marked out, you know, scripts or, you know, someone sends you PDFs with scribbles on them and things like that, that doesn't work. So we've got an opportunity with this technology for the client to have a light edit function.
Nice.
And they can get in there, have a play, correct a word here, correct a word there. And it makes that whole process a lot faster and a lot easier for them.
So sort of you eyes it to the company.
Exactly.
Right?
Yeah. Yeah.
And it sounds like the message is, hey, we're going to bring this training to the person.
Mm-hmm.
We don't necessarily have to bring the person to the training anymore.
Sure. Yeah. And that's exactly right. One of the biggest issues that compliance officers talk to us about is the amount of pushback that they get.
Right.
Every year they're rolling out training and the management team saying, why do my people have to do this? And they're saying that because their staff are pushing back on them and saying, why do I have to do this again? And everyone knows the answer.
Right.
You know, we have to do it. It's mandatory. We need to be able to prove to the regulator, but it needs to be better.
Interesting. So for someone who's interested in wanting to learn more and take a deeper dive, how do they get in contact with you?
Go straight to our website, grcsolutions.co, and you'll find all the contact details for either people here in New York or New Zealand or Singapore or Australia, and someone will call you right back.
Fantastic. Is that .co or .co?
.co.
Okay.
Yeah.
Excellent. Well, thank you, Julian. Appreciate it. Pleasure. Out.